Howdy everybody, Brian, Indiana Creek Gold. Just showed up to the honey hole and there's a freaking claim jumper here already. Rain Man stopped by the house and then headed on up here. We had Jackson's birthday parties finishing it up. So yeah, we're back at the honey hole. Gonna dig a couple buckets. I brought my metal detector. Old Ron F. lost a silver ring that was made out of 1 ounce silver round right around in here last year. So I'm going to swing around, maybe see if we come up with something. And then before we leave, I might run, walk up by the where the old mill was at and maybe walk around on top of the island here and see if we come across something. That mill was there from late 1800s, you know, up until early 1900s. So might be a goodie or two up there. So let's dig some material and we'll see if we can find some gold. All right, we are ready to go. We have dug four buckets of hopefully primo material. Richard has accumulated probably 150 pounds of rocks to carry out so far. Yeah, we've got time left. It's 4:30. We're getting ready to set the sluices up. It's dark as hell in 3 hours here in Indiana now. So we're gonna run some material from the honey hole. I gotta get my screws out here for the RPE that I did remember to bring. I only have our microphone case there. Two sections today. Not doing the long tom version. So, put this baby together real quick. Beautiful day. Beautiful, beautiful day here in West Central Indiana. Leaves are all starting to change and fall. Water's back down again. So, it came up a little bit. We had a couple days of rain. Didn't last long. Everything's really dry again. So, yep. Let me try to get this started here. Let me use two hands. I'll be back. There. Got it together. Ready to go now. Let me get this set up. I want to set up front pretty hot. So, let me get something figured out where we can get our bucket set up, set my ass on one, and then feed the sluice. So my phone's slick as hell without the case that I keep complaining about with this receiver, Bluetooth receiver for the microphone. So I don't want to have it out there with me trying to get this set up and a rock set on it and everything. So we shall return. Another camo moon brought to you by the Rain Man, A3 Sky Warrior. All right, we're back. I do believe I have dropped the Bluetooth receiver from my microphone and it is just flat gone. I have looked, I had it on my phone in the charging port, had my phone in my pocket, charging port down, I do believe, but pulled my phone out a while ago, had to send a text back, and yeah, there's no receiver, so the audio was sucking beforehand. We know that was a problem, so I got it, so hopefully it ain't too bad. I'll try to hold the phone close. Rain Man already has a chunker up in the top of his RPE, so we have 2 3-quarter buckets to run, and hopefully we'll get a chunk or two. It might be too hot. Oh no, looks like it's gonna work out all right. I can get a little more in there, a little more flow. Let's do that. Right here on this side. We'll just stick that rock out. in front up there, maybe a little bit. Set it back it up here. Damn it. Alright, we're gonna have to do a little modifying here. Wow, that water is cold already. Get a little more flow in here. Plug this up over here on the other side of our bucket. Go from there. We've got a little bit of a dead spot right there. I think we can work with it. Put it up here in this corner. We'll work down across there. Side's low. Tell that. All the material's loading up there on that side. So we need to do something about that. Yeah, she's running hot. We just moved it, didn't we? I really don't like how it's loading up there at the end, but probably needs a little more angle to it, but it is what it is. I said it's definitely optimal water flow. But we're getting by. It's working it like it should. Rain man. I didn't make it down here till sort of late. He's on that third shift sleep schedule. But a few hours on the water with Rain Man's definitely worth it. Come on, chunkers. We found some really nice flakes and chunkers into there. Richard said he did some test panning. I'm sorry if the audio's sucking. I know this water's loud, and I was sort of holding my phone far away. But he did some test panning and found a few pieces. So hopefully the honey hole produces possibly a chunker up there, but I don't know about that, not sure on that. So yeah, I can't believe I lost that receiver. Well, I can't, I've dropped it in the water just up here at the waterfall once already. So yeah. I had to keep reminding myself to not put it in my shirt pocket and stuff like that, and then I'd drop it off my phone. So, yeah. So, let me put the phone up so I don't drop the damn thing. Probably can't hear me anyway. And we'll run this material down. Alright. We ran that first two-thirds of a bucket. RPE setting up there. We're going to do a clean out. We'll take a peek up in the top so we can see. I didn't see any chunkers up there. It was running pretty hot. So, I mean, a lot of the material was moving down into the riffles probably before it had a chance to do its thing. Richard's on his second bucket. sort of relaxing, taking a break. I had me a bit to eat, getting a drink, smoke break, and we're gonna get back with it, run that other bucket, and we'll probably just throw the cleanup on this video. I'm probably gonna be taking a whole lot of video today, but we'll take a peek in the RPE here in a second. All right, let's zoom in here and see if we can see any visible gold. Sort of hard to tell. That looks like it might be a piece there when it's cloudy like this. Sun's going down. Like I said, it's, we're not far away from getting dark. So, yeah. Nothing real visible right off the bat. Like I said, it's hard to see. I guess I turned my light on. But swung the detector all over the rock bar here. And no sign of Ron S. silver ring he lost. Bummer there. But let's get this rinsed out. We got another part of a bucket to run. Oh, there's some gold right there, maybe. I don't know. We'll find out when we clean it up, I guess. So, I'm going to get this dumped out and grab Richard's pan so I can rinse that out. And we're in another bucket before it gets dark. Alright, we're pretty much back where we was before. I have the RP a little bit farther down. We're going to see how it runs here, not with the crap. Okay. Back up here where it was at. Did the job before. So, should work again. Okay, I'm going to have to do some fine tuning. The bucket needs to be up here. Pumping that float water. Make you sitting closer. And this rock needs to be right here. This one probably standing up actually would be even better. All right, let's see where we're at there. Not great. There we go. That's where we need to be. Yeah, let me modify this and run it down. We went through this bucket. There's a little bit left stuck in here. We're gonna try to rinse it out. And I'm gonna steal Richard's pan here for a minute. And we'll take a little peek at maybe some gold. Oh, my back's killing me. Hips sitting on that bucket too long. Like I said, I realize the audio probably sucks on this again, and I'm sorry. I'll have to order a new, see if I can order a new receiver without having to order the whole deal. Again, I didn't see any chunkers in the top of our RPE, but running pretty hot, and I was going way too fast. So I know a lot of the material was just blowing down into the riffles instead of going across the indicators. Had a good showing for Jackson's birthday party today. Him and his couple of his buddies decorated the house really cool for Halloween. I'll probably share that with you all. Maybe want to do cleanup. They did a good job. Getting down to some pretty good heavies now. Do our tap tap on this rock here. And, hold on for a minute. Alright, we got the light on. Zoom in a little bit so I can see too. There will not be any material when we get back over the RPE in there. It's running pretty hot. I moved some rocks around so it would help clean it out. I like this little Garrett gold trap. Nice little pin. Man, I don't know. Compared to the last few trips we had up here, we must have worked through that pocket of gold or that layer that was holding the gold, because today has not quite panned out. Some small stuff. Yeah, definitely nothing to get very excited about. There's some small pieces in there, that's it. We will catch and release that flood gold. Hopefully there's more in the sluice. Okay, nothing in the top of the indicators, but it was pretty blown out. So, hopefully there's a some gold in our cleanup. I said maybe we got out of the deal. You know, I mean, when we was high banking up here a couple times too, that's the same deal. You know, same everywhere. Get into pockets of good gold.
Mr. Pocket is elusive.
Rain Man probably just sucked up a big old chunker though right here. We got a little bit of daylight left. I want to throw on my long sleeve shirt and we'll walk up there to the mill real quick with a detector. Okay, we were randomly walking here and found a signal right here. I don't have my pinpointer with me. So, what I'm doing is put material up there. So hopefully whatever it is will end up there and we can get a tone on it. Oh, it's still there. Oh, it's probably that piece of concrete there. Thank you. Well, that was probably one. Hey, right there. Some of these rocks. I'm thinking it's probably rebar in that concrete or wire. Or maybe some lead. Probably won't. Yeah, we're not going to keep digging there. Let me put my phone up. All right, the opening to the old mill is right there. We got a signal right there. Should have brought my plastic scooper. It's all sand. Oh, we're upside down, I see. What the hell happened there? Yeah, I'll come back if we find something. All right, we had to do some serious digging, but found a piece of aluminum. We'll just rebury that. Come back if we find another signal. I'd walked around quite a bit up through here. Here's the opening where the mill was. We got a random signal right there. So let me poke around, see what we can find. Whatever it is, we can't get to it with the tools we have. It's solid chunks of rock there. So I'm running short on record time. So I think we're gonna wander back down toward Richard and we'll wrap it up down there. All right, we're back down here. Old A3 Sky Warrior, Rain Man. Fish just took off. Another one right there. Oh, probably struggling in here. Not a whole lot of oxygen in this water. Beautiful sunset. The leaves are changing. Those maple trees back there. The yellow one right there. Yeah, we'll be doing a cleanup there at the house. I'll try to get that in tomorrow. And yeah, this will probably be our Tuesday video. I doubt it. I get it up tomorrow. YouTube is not working with me on the uploading, editing thing. So, on behalf of a couple of us Indiana boys, I thank you for hanging out, following along on these adventures. And I guess the video's not ending, but next time I'm talking to you, we'll be there at the table. Seeing what the hell's in these cons. Hopefully there's some gold. Y'all take care. I will see you shortly. You won't even know I'm gone. All right, folks. We are back. Finally getting around to doing these cons. Wife's been off work all week. Jackson's been on spring break.
We've been trying to get stuff done around here all week. Been busy, trying to get ready for winter. Hauling stuff away, getting in firewood, all that good stuff, cleaning up, getting into deer season. So, but yeah, I've been wanting to get to this. Richard, the rain man, said he went through his last night and didn't do great, which I think we got off that line of gold that we had been following there at the honey hole. I think we might have it figured out where to go next, but this one didn't seem that great. But like I said, this stuff's just about dried out. This is not the best scooper for this. But we're going to do a quarter inch. And then kitchen strainer as usual. I doubt there's anything in the plus quarter. We can always hope. Cool looking rock, so. Chunk of quartz, another chunk of quartz down there. Piece of bedrock. Piece of rhyolite right there. So, if you followed along, we got over our 3,000 hours. I appreciate everybody helping out on that deal. Been a long time working getting here. So, getting everything set up, that's sort of a hassle. But I'm going to try the members deal for right now instead of doing Patreon. The difference is, we'll do this bigger stuff, is you cannot have a contest on YouTube for members that one person gets something that everybody else does not get. So, and we'll go into this more. What I plan on doing, let me try and get out this. Right here is 4 times a year everybody that's a member will get a package sent to them. Everybody, there's some nice garnets in there. So compensatory, whatever that word is, compensatory to whatever tier you are in. So, and we'll see how it goes. I might just drop it, I don't know. I there's a little bit for in there for everybody, so you know, every 3 months, you know, be getting anything from stickers to pay dirt to gold pans to maybe sluices, you know, stuff like that. But we'll get that figured out as we go. I figured due to the every 3 months thing, everybody in each tier is getting the same thing. A few specks of small gold up there. I don't see any chunkers. So, all kinds of garnets in there though. We're definitely on the garnets. So there's 11 or 12 small pieces there. Not a bad start. Let's get this wash back. All right. A little better peek at them little pieces there. Most of them washed down the pan, looks like. Had to do the snuffer bottle dance. I got 3 good snuffer bottles. I can find one, and it had a bunch of shiny in it already. Look, there's that Indiana shaped flake that I found over the hill there, shaped like the state of Indiana. That thing stands out. So these big chunkers were not Indiana. It was not Indiana gold. That's like crystalline stuff there. Most of the other is though. Been on the gold this year. I actually gave. Yeah, we'll just catch and release that little stuff. My two biggest pieces of gold that I found this year away this weekend to my niece and nephew. Oh, Alex and Sophia Brown were here for Jackson's birthday party. And we were out checking out gold. And yeah, they never held real gold, you know, natural gold. So I give them that 0.15 chunk we found and the biggest flake that I found. So they were all excited about that. So was I. So let me take a break here. I think wife's here with the grand puppy. Got back from the groomer. Okay, we have returned. Where we're at here. Nolly is back, freshly bathed and toenails clipped. Went to the doggy spa. Millie has great anxiety. Millie, the gold sniffing dog, when I take her. Last time I took her there, I usually take her and baby together, and it was just Millie. And Millie wrapped her, hopped up, and wrapped her front legs around my thigh tighter than any of my kids ever have. It was sort of sad. She has separation anxiety. Right, let me move this stuff around so we got better light. All right, it might be a little better. Come on, chocolate. Sounds like something's rattling around in there. Richard, like I said, I've seen his clean up, and it was not great compared to what we have been getting out of there. More big old pink garnets. Once you get over the hill, they're usually like the dark burgundy. These are really light pink. Some of them are almost orange looking. A bunch more of that small gold up there. Oh. All right. Shoot, we don't want to drag this out forever, do we? Let's run through this pan here. And then I'll just blast through this stuff. And we'll come back and have a look-see. A lot of material on there. Garnet showing up. Not had a whole lot of luck in the deer hunting department. Coles passed on a few. Little fawns and a video to small buck. I really haven't had anything close enough to pass on. Down where I've been sitting under the bridge, I watch 2 to 5 deer every evening up on the neighbors up underneath oak trees about 100 yards away. And I've seen deer. I had a big doe the other night 40 yards away. I mean, I can shoot 50. Shots are possible at 60 with my crossbow, but I probably wouldn't do it. But I mean, I thought she was going to walk by at 20. So let me zoom this in. I didn't take that 40 yard shot. But she turned and headed up the hill to where all the other deer were munching on acorns instead. So, but I did 2 nights ago watch a buck. I never could tell how big it was. I'm pretty sure it wasn't a monster by any means. But it was chasing a doe around over on the west side of our property for 10 minutes. I thought it was squirrels, because I could tell something was running in circles, crash, 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 and I kept seeing squirrels over there up in the trees, and so I kept looking. I seen some white flashing around, and I said the buck was chasing a doe around in real tight circles, trying to keep her trapped in there. Just solid garnets. But they headed downstream. We should start coming upstream, as per typical. Good looking stuff there. But back to the members thing. My own money's tight for everybody now. I mean, that's just a simple fact. But I've got a tier for just about anybody. I think $3 up to $40. $40 tier gets a package right off the bat. I'm like sitting in every 3 months. Everybody gets a package every 3 months from the date that you join. I will be sending out something cool to all the members. Their triversary every 3 months. Shoulder has been killing me, and this is not doing it any favors. I think I might have to postpone the hip surgery and get my shoulder worked on, because it is going to make recovery from hip surgery rough, getting up off a chair or bed or toilet, anything like that, because I can't hardly reach my arm behind me. I like grimace in pain every time I put a jacket or a coat on or off. So I cannot lift myself up, you know, help myself get up with that right arm whatsoever. It's angry right now, all swollen up. But I've been putting it off for nay on 2 years now. Surgery on my shoulder. I kept saying, well, it could get better on its own. It ain't going to get better. It would have. But 6 weeks in a sling, so might be doing that. I don't know. I've got to talk to my surgeon. He'll be the same one doing it. He gave me a choice. Hey, which hip, your knee or your shoulder? What do you want to do first? And my hip bothers me all the time. It affects my sleep, how far I can walk, going up and down steps. But I sort of learned to live with it. My shoulder literally stops me from doing a lot of stuff. I mean, it's hard for me to reach up with my right arm to put stuff in the microwave and get stuff out of the microwave. It's that bad. And this is a daily. So, you know, chronic pain versus immobility. I think, I said, I'm going to have the right arm to be able to use to recover for the hip. Come on, something. Said, there's a piece of gold anyway. Richard's cleanup was about the poorest I think he's had this year. Me and Mike ran down over the hill here one day, Mike from Indy, and we did not do very well at all. We didn't strike out, but we didn't do great. A little bit more showing up over there. Flower gold, flower gold. And you can flip that stuff back there with a good seasoned pan like this. Not looking good for the honey hole. So we're definitely off that line of gold. Let me work through all this stuff, and I will show you what we ended up with. Hopefully it gets better. All right, we have pretty much struck out. We've got a little bit of minus kitchen strainer left. This is the last of the big stuff. But there is a piece of gold in there. Y'all probably can't hear me because I was covering the crappy microphone up. I'm going to have to research into getting another Bluetooth receiver since I dropped the other one in the creek the other day. I still need to go through my backpack. It might have fell off in there. But, it's no more than big old garnets. Pretty garnets, not so pretty garnets. And one little chunker. Yeah, let's call that a sort of thick flake. It's more flakish. It's pretty flat. Yeah, honey hole, I said we got off the gold, definitely. Let's get this small stuff pan through, and we shall do a stuff or dump. Not look great for the home team. Hopefully this last pan's loaded. We can always hope. Okay, this is pretty bad. This is by far the worst cleanup of the year. Definitely off the gold. Was a great day on the water with the rain, man. So, I mean, it was worth that to me. We got some cool video out of it. But we were definitely off that line of gold. Try to look sun and no sun here. But that small gold, that one flake. And I catch that one really pretty big garnet. But, right there it is. I mean, you could about count the pieces. That's a rock down there. But, yeah. We're going to have to relocate. I think Ron S. coming up tomorrow. And we'll get into some kind of adventure. Might do a little metal detecting. Never know about us. But, like when me and Rain Man get out, we'll definitely have some fun. So, catch you on the next one. Thanks for hanging out. I'm going to drop my phone in the water. out chasing that Indiana gold, wrapping it up, waiting for the rain man. RPE just sluicing it today. I think we might have pushed through our line of gold at the honey hole. Not looking great today. Get her next time.